So many Nigerians who are saying let's do electronic voting are blaming INEC for not trying to do electronic voting. But there is a legal provision that says electronic voting is prohibited. So now people are hoping that the National Assembly will remove that encumbrance, not necessarily for INEC to plunge in electronic voting in 2023 or before then, but at least they will now begin to identify the different electronic voting systems, to identify which are adaptable, to find out which they can begin piloting, and so on and so forth. Things that they could not do before because of that legal hindrance. And then people are saying, in any case, electronic transmission of results is easier to deploy. It's more cost effective compared to use of electronic voting. You know, so why not begin with electronic transmission of results? The current so-called two dominant parties, in particular the APC and the PDP, with their faulty recruitment and leadership selection processes, who have shared power and have tended to lead Nigeria, I'm sorry to say, astray in the past 21 years, are becoming incapable of the directing Nigerian political and governance processes in the right direction. The dominant elite in these parties are self-centered, are preventing the few good ones amongst them to be impactful. They are also fractious and quarrelsome and lacking even in what I call enlightened self-interest. Because sometimes you sacrifice your personal interest in order for the system to stabilize, to legitimize. So we need to create a new special purpose vehicle, or even new special purpose vehicles, but that can go into alliance and work together in order to free our country from the stranglehold placed on it by reckless, vigilant, and parochial politicians.